Hello and welcome, welcome, welcome back to the Django 4.x ORM Mastery Course YouTube edition. This tutorial is part of a playlist, don't forget. You can access that playlist link in the video description. We further our knowledge of creating models in this tutorial by learning how to add a verbose name to Django model fields. If you would like the code base, the code source for this tutorial, or would like to follow along, don't forget there is a code zero setup tutorial in this playlist where you'll be able to learn how to start and prepare the application that we are running, the Django application, so that you can follow along step by step in this tutorial. Don't forget, if you like what you see in this tutorial series, then there is a much more complete structured learning experience on Udemy, our Udemy course related to the Django ORM. You'll find the link to the course in the video description. All field types except foreign keys, many-to-many fields, and one-to-one fields can take an optional first position argument. That is the verbose name. Now, simply put, the verbose name is a human-readable name for the field. So let's imagine that we had some sort of field here which represented the data in some sort of way or your business requirements. Now, this isn't necessarily a very human readable name to utilize. Now, behind the scenes, once we go into the Django admin, for example, the Django admin will use the verbose names of these fields. Now, Django does provide a default verbose name. So we end up using the default verbose name for this field, which would just be name, for example, in this case. So if we wanted our field to be displayed, the name to be displayed in a slightly different way in the admin and maybe in different forms that we generate in our Django project, then we simply just add the verbose name. So here, for example, in this character field, we just go ahead and add a new name. So maybe this is actually called the brand name, or we want to output by default the brand name and not the word name. So now when we go into the admin, we find that the name for this field is now brand name and not name. So that's all we really need to know about verbose names. For those who would like to, you can stay on. We'll go through and have a look at that actually in action in the Django admin. So this is code base zero. So let's just go ahead and Python 3 manage.py. Let's make migrations, and then we'll run and migrate. So let's run migrate. So that just prepares and creates all the tables. So let's go ahead now and run Python 3 manage.py and then create super user so we can access the admin. So we're going to use the username admin, no email address, and then admin. So I type in the word admin there. You can't see it, but it's there. And then admin again, and then y. Okay, right. So now we can go ahead and Python manage.py run the server. Okay, so now the server is running. Let's go ahead and have a look at the admin. So you'll need to navigate to the local host and then slash and then admin. That will take you to the admin login. So the username is admin, password admin. And then you can see that we have a number of different models here. So let's go into the brands and let's add a new brand. And you can see that this form is now using brand name. That's the verbose name that we've just defined. So let's go back in here. Let's just change this name, for example, back to the default. So the default verbose name, Django would just utilize the name of the field here, this attribute, which is just name. If we do have any words like this, for example, brand ID, we'll have a look in a second. We can't do that, but let's... If Django were to find any field names with an underscore, then Django would use the default verbose name. It would basically replace the underscore here with a space. Right, so let's go back in and refresh, and we can see that the verbose name now is name. So here we can see in this demonstration the verbose name in action. This isn't the only place where the verbose name might come into play in your Django project. If you were to build a Django project and you created an automatic form, then Django would more likely utilize the name, the verbose name of your fields to generate your form. So there the verbose name is also being utilized. So you can imagine at this point that in your form, name might not be the most descriptive way of describing this field. So having, for example, like we saw earlier, brand name here, when you generate your own forms, that might be a better descriptor for that particular field. So we will later in this course learn more about foreign keys, many-to-many fields, and one-to-one fields. But it's important to remember that the verbose field name is not an optional first position argument for those field types. So we can only really utilize those on the, I call them standard field types. So the character fields, here we've got an integer field, a Boolean field, but you can see we have a many-to-many field. So this is an example where we couldn't utilize a verbose field name.